Hello, welcome to Hands That Rock Crochet with me, Kenny. I'm going to show you how to make this beautiful, gorgeous blanket. It's something that I made for a beautiful princess. She's been asking for it for a very long time. If you need to make a gift for anyone, maybe for Christmas or anything like that, birthday and so on, this is one project that you can make. So gather your crochet materials and let's go on the crochet journey. Use any scrap yarns. Make sure that the colors, you group them in shades that are of similar colors, and then scissors, 4.0mm crochet hook. Now we're gonna make a slip knot like so. And chain, pass your hook through first, like so, and then make a chain multiple of 14 plus 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Carry on and make yours as long as you want it to be. I am gonna make 42 multiple of 14 plus 3, making 45 chain stitches for this project. The best way you know your size is make it as long as you know the blanket size you want to, or the bed size you want to. Now we're going to go into the first back hump. Yarn over and pull through. You have two loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through two. You've made one single crochet. Into the next back hump, pull through, make another single crochet. Into the one after that, make a single crochet. Carry on making your single crochets. You have three single crochets so far. 1, 2, 3. Make it all the way down the length of your chain stitches. Pass your hook through to make a single crochet, pull over two loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through two. I have 42 single crochet. I'm gonna go in there, make another single crochet. Into the next, we'll make a single crochet. Into the very last, make a single crochet, making a total of 45 single crochet. Now leave the last two loops on your hook and do not cut your yarn. Take your next color that you want to use, pass your hook through, and then we begin. Now one thing I need to tell you is your first color will be your base color. So this is your second color. Now we're going to work over our yarn tail. So pass your tail like so. Pass your hook through and pull and make a single crochet. Into the next, we make a single crochet working over our yarn tails as we go along. That's two single crochets we've done. Into the next, we make single crochet, yarn over and pull through. We've made 1, 2, 3 single crochets. The next one we're going to yarn over and make half double crochet. One half double crochet into the next, like so. Yarn over again into the next, make an half double crochet. So you've made 3 single crochets, 2 half double crochet. Into the next, we're going to make one double crochet to the next like so. You have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through 2 and pull through 2. Yarn over 2 loops on your hook and go into the next and make another double crochet. We're gonna cut the remaining of the tail now because we've weaved it enough, like so. So with your scissors, snip the red or whatever color you're using. That's it. Yarn over twice. You have 3 loops on your hook. Into the next, we're going to make triple crochet, like so. Yarn over twice. Into the next, we make triple crochet, pull through 2 and pull through 2. Yarn over twice. Into the next, we make triple crochet. So this forms the peak of your pattern. You're going up. Now make a double crochet to come back down. Yarn over again and into the next, make a double crochet. Yarn over. You have 2 loops on your hook. In there, we're going to make half double crochet. Into the next, half double crochet. There we make single crochet 1, single crochet 2, and single crochet into the next. You have completed the first part of your pattern, of your wave. So now yarn over, we carry on. We're going to make half double crochet again because we're going up. Yarn over, half double crochet into the next, like so. Pull through all 3. Yarn over and make double crochet. Yarn over, double crochet into the next, pull through 2 and pull through 2. Yarn over twice. We're going back up like what we've done. We're going to repeat it on this side. Go in there, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. We're going to make 2 double yarn overs in there, and then we make a triple crochet. Triple crochet the third time to go right up to the peak. Now, this is how the pattern is forming. You have 2 loops on your hook. You're going to make a double crochet. So basically, you're going to carry on following this pattern down the length of your stitch or your blanket. Half double crochet and into the next, we make single crochet and single crochet. You can see the wave or the ripple pattern forming, like so. So we're repeating again. We yarn over, 2 loops on the hook, go into the space, pull through 3 to make a half double crochet, make another half double crochet into the next. Now into the next space, we're going to make like so. Carry on, triple crochet into the next. Triple crochet into the next, we make triple crochet. Yarn over. This is how the pattern is looking so far. In there, we make double crochet, yarn over, double crochet, and then we yarn over. Half double crochet into the next 2. So you will have 3 single crochets, for one for each left. this is how it's looking so far. Now yarn over, turn over, and turn over. We're going to repeat the pattern of what we've done before on top of it to make a thicker wave or ripple effect. So you're going to single crochet into the first, single into the next, and into the third single crochet. Now you yarn over and make half double crochet like what you've done on the previous side. Yarn over, half double crochet into the next, and then yarn over, and in there you make your double crochet. Double crochet again to go up the hill, and then we make our triple crochet. This is what we've done so far, like so. You're going up and up. So we're coming back down with the double crochet in each next two. Yarn over, half double crochet in each next two. And then single crochet in each of the next three stitches, like so. Half double crochet, and we're gonna go up again. Triple crochet. Yarn over twice. This is what we've done so far. Triple crochet into the next. Yarn over. Sorry, yarn over twice. Triple crochet. Yarn over two loops on your hook. Make double crochet, yarn over, double crochet. So we yarn over, we make half double crochet into the next two. This is exactly what we've done on the previous row. We're just making it wider. Now you single crochet into the next, and single crochet. Yarn over, half double crochet, yarn over, half double crochet into the next, yarn over, double crochet into the next two, chain space. Yarn over, and we're going to make our triple crochet into the next three spaces. On top of each triple crochet, you make your triple crochet just like so. Three loops on your hook, pull through and pull through two each time you yarn over. And you make your double crochet, half double crochet, and half double crochet into the next, and you have three single crochets left. So on top of each you make one single crochet. When you get to the end, you have two loops on your hook. You can snip your yarn if you want to, like so. Your main color, you carry it along the side. You can always add a single crochet border for your edging. So this is how you pull through, and that helps in carrying your yarn along, and you don't have to be cutting your main yarn all the time. Now we're going to walk over our yarn tail like so into the first single crochet. There we're going to make single crochet. So with our main color yarn, you only make single crochet on top of each stitches, just like so. Don't forget to walk over your yarn tail. We've made three single crochets, so carry on. So make a single crochet, go into the space that you want to walk into, yarn over, pull through, and pull through two. This is how it will be looking so far. When you walk over your yarn tail, you have less to weave in after. Single crochet all the way down. And this is how it will be looking like. This is another color sample for you here. For each wavelength, from the low valley to the high valley and low valley to the other side, you have 17 stitches. But for the multiples, you need 14 stitches plus 3, like so from the top. And you're doing it twice to give you the fuller wave effect. So you're going to start with three single crochets and so on, like it's written down there. Carry on making your single crochets to frame your wave pattern. Whatever color you like, you can choose as your main color for framing your blanket. So it binds the color together like so. Now this is just to show you that when you finish the full two repeat, you're going to come back down and make three triple crochet instead of three single crochets, like so. First, attach your new color yarn as we've done previously. Remember to walk over your yarn tail. Now we're going to chain 4 chain stitches to form our first triple crochet. And over twice, you have three loops on your hook. Into the next space, we're going to make our triple crochet. Remember to leave your main color yarn attached because you're going to carry it. You can cut it if you find it easier. Into the next, make your triple crochet. We've done three triple crochets so far. Into the next, we're going to make double crochet. And into the next, we make a double crochet. So we go from now on, we're going to follow the pattern again by going up the valley. By going up the hill and then down the valley. So here we're making our single crochet. This is how it will be looking so far. Yarn over, In there, make your half double crochet into the next half double crochet, yarn over. I'm going to make double crochet into the next two space. You have three loops on your hook. We're going to start by making our triple crochet. So where in the previous pattern, where you have your valleys, you're going to have your heels, and where you have your heels, you're going to have your valleys, like so. You can see. So we're going back down by making double crochet and double crochet into the next. Now in there we make half double crochet, yarn over, half double crochet. We're going to single crochet one, single crochet into the next, and single crochet. And we start all over again by doing half double crochet into the next two, and then double crochet into the next two. Yarn over twice. This is how it's looking so far. Make triple crochet in each of the next three spaces. Into the next one, this is how it's looking so far. We're going to make double crochet into the next two, make a double crochet each. And then we go back down by doing half double crochet in each of the next two. Single crochet in each of the next three spaces, and we go back up. Double crochet, double crochet, yarn over twice, and we begin to make our triple crochet into the next, triple crochet. You're going to have one more left, so you just make your double crochet in there, like so. This is how it's looking so far. Turn your work, and we're going to repeat exactly what we've done. We're going to make three chain stitches to form our double crochet in there. Yarn over twice, three loops on the hook, make your triple crochet. Another triple crochet into the next, and triple crochet into the one after that. Make your double crochet and double crochet into the next. Next two, we're going to make single crochets into, sorry, we're going to make half double crochets into each. Now we make single crochet into each of the next three spaces along. It's just repeating what we have done at the bottom to form a complete wavelength. Then over in there, we're going to make double crochet. Now we need to yarn over twice to make triple crochet into the next three. Yarn over three and in there make triple crochet. This is how it's looking so far. Into the next we make double crochets into each, and then half double crochet into the next two and single crochet in there, single crochet into the next, single crochet in there. Yarn over, carry on, follow the pattern all the way down. Triple crochet, triple crochet, triple crochet. Double crochet in there, double crochet in there, half double crochet into the next two, so the pattern is very repetitive. You need to carry on all the way down the length of your blanket. Half double crochet, half double crochet, and double crochet, double crochet, and then make your triple crochets to finish that row. So when you finish, make sure you have two loops on your hook. You can cut your main yarn if you want, or pass through the side like so. Pull through and secure it. Turn your work, and we're going to be using the main color. This is how it's looking so far. Walk over any yarn tail that you have, or you can walk over. Makes it easier for you at the end. Single crochet all the way down on top of each with your main color. For this blanket, you can use any scrap yarn that you have lying about. Just if you run out when you're doing the wave pattern, just use it and join. Now we're going to sew in. I'll show you how to sew in your ends if you cut your yarn and you need to do so. Just pass your needle through like so and pull through. Make sure you weave in the right color to the right area so it doesn't show. Snip and carry on with your single crochets. So if you're making a wave pattern and you notice that you ran out of the yarn, just pick up another yarn and carry on to do your wave pattern. Then the single part of the single crochet part of the pattern, use one main color for that. Single crochet into the single crochet. There you go. Once you've made it long enough, tie and snip. And there you go. This is how it will be looking like. So you can see in my blanket, like so, and the way the color has been grouped together, it looks quite nice. So the reddish purplish color grouped together. Now you notice that where you have your rising of the wave, it's staggered when you go to the next two up, like so. And cream color was used for the single crochets to bind it together. Thank you so much for tuning into this crochet channel. We really appreciate you. If you haven't subscribed, maybe you accidentally come across this crochet channel and you like some more videos, please feel free to subscribe and click the notification bell as well. Okay, we hope to see you soon on another exciting production from Ask the Real Crochet. Till then, take care and have a good crochet journey. Bye-bye.